Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to see two examples of how can we use propositional equivalences. A compound proposition that is always true is called a tautology. And if the value of that proposition is always false, then it's called a contradiction. So compound propositions P and Q are logically equivalent if the biconditional P if and only if Q is a tautology. And we are going to use this symbol to denote that P and Q are logically equivalent. You might recall from my previous videos, in mathematics, definitions matter. If we don't know the definitions, we won't be able to do everything we could do by using mathematics. So now we are going to see two examples that although you won't see these specific definitions, what we are going to do, it is based on these two definitions. That's why it is important that you know and understand these two definitions. As a first example, we are going to show that no P or Q is logically equivalent to P implies Q. So how are we going to do this? Okay, we have two options. In this case, you can see we only have two propositional variables. So the easier way in these cases, it will be to create the truth table for both compound propositions. And if the truth values for both compound propositions are the same, then it means they are logically equivalent. So if we don't know how to create truth tables, you can go and check the video on the description on how to create truth tables. So here, as you see, we have the values for no P or Q, and we have the truth values for P implies Q. As you can see, these truth values are the same. Because these truth values are the same, we can conclude that the two propositions are logically equivalent. Very easy, isn't it? So anytime you are asked to prove that two compound propositions are logically equivalent, and there are only two variables in the compound propositions, then my recommendation is to use truth tables. It's the easy way to go. So when we have two variables, we will only have four rows on the truth table. But if there are three variables, we are going to have eight. But if there are four variables, we are going to have 16. So it is not really practical to use this approach to prove that any couple of compound propositions are equivalent. So we need to use another method when there are more than two variables involved. So in this example, we have to show that two compound propositions are logically equivalent by developing a series of logical equivalences. As you see, in this case, we are asked specifically not to use truth tables. So how can we proceed? As you see on the right side, there are already some logical equivalences that have been proved, and therefore we can use them. So the way that you use them is you just apply it and you refer to the name. So let's see how can we do it. So first, we are going to modify the proposition on the left, and we are going to try to obtain the proposition that is in the right. There is no rule or algorithm that shows us what transformations we must do. This is like a trial and error. You start trying some transformations. If you don't get the expected results, then you go back and try other transformations. So in our case, we are going to start applying the second Morgan law. As you see here, we have the Morgan laws, which are these two, and we are going to apply the second one because it's the one that we can apply here. As you can see, we have a no, and then we have an or within the parentheses. So this one is the one that we should apply now. So let's just apply it then. So this is no P and no P and Q. Now, what we just did here, as you see, no P or Q. In our case, we have P here, or, and this is our Q. And then we have no P, and, like in this case, no, and this is our Q, which is the same as this one. So this is how we apply it, okay? But after we apply the law, we have to state in written what law we applied. If we don't write what law we applied, then there is an error, okay? So every step we have to justify. So now what we can do is to use another equivalence to keep modifying the new proposition that we got. So in this case, we have an and here, and then we have a no and an and. So if we check on this side, we have here no P and Q, and we can transform that in something else. So it is the same here, we have no, this is our P and this is Q. So we're just going to apply, in this case, the first Morgan law. And the rest remains the same. So we have no P or no Q. Okay? And then we just say that this is the first Morgan law. Okay, what can we do now? So if you see this here, we should be able to simplify this, okay? Then let's look at the table on this side. We have exactly the same here, and this is called the double negation law. So we can say that this is logically equivalent to this because of the double negation law. I hope you can now see the pattern here. Let's keep transforming the new proposition that we got. In this case, we are just going to apply this law that we have here. As you can see, we have P and then within the parentheses we have an OR, which is exactly what we have here. So let's apply it and let's see what happens. This is no P and P, or no P and no Q. And we just use the second distributive law. As you can see here, you just need to follow the formula. If you follow the formula, you won't make any mistake. So now from here, we can see that we have no P and P. This is a contradiction and it is false, like you can see here, okay? So, although here we have no P and P, and here we have P and no P, we can say it is the same because we can first apply the commutative law that states that P and Q is logically equivalent to Q and P. So here we can apply two laws in one and say this is false, or no P and no Q, and it is false because first we apply commutative law and then we apply the negation law. As you can see, we are justifying every single step that we take. So if you see one law that we have here, it states that P or false is logically equivalent to P. But we have false or P. So what can we do here? We first can use a commutative law to change the order. You see P or Q is logically equivalent to Q or P. So we can just say here that this is logically equivalent to no P and no Q, or false by the commutative law And then we can say that this is logically equivalent to no P and no Q because of the identity law. As you can see here, the identity law states that P or false is logically equivalent to P. In our case, this is P or false. That's why we can just state this result. And then we just finish the exercise. As you can see, it is quite straightforward to follow the series of logical equivalences. The problem here, the complexity of this type of exercise, is that there is no algorithm that can tell you what logical equivalence you must use and in what order. So the more exercises of this type you solved, the better you will get at solving them. So my recommendation here is to solve all the exercises you can solve of this type, and then you will become better at finding out what logical equivalences you must apply at each time. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you in the next video.